and welcome viewers. I'm Idris, and in this program that is Lifeline, today we are going to discuss about coronavirus and agriculture sector in India. The nationwide lockdown contains the outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic in India has brought economic activity to a complete standstill. During these times of crisis, when most of the sectors in the economy are in a slump, the agriculture sector has risen to become a beacon of hope and has the promise of the leading country's economy recovery. As the least affected sector from the coronavirus-induced recession, the agriculture sector cannot only be leveraged in the process of recovery, but it could also gain from the opportunity by leapfrogging into a new regime of growth, development, and enhanced farmer welfare. Well, it is widely acknowledged that access to credit is critical for accessing timely and good quality inputs at the time of sowing and significantly after the post-harvest management of crops during harvest. The International Food Policy Research Institute, that is IFPRI, based on a large field survey of nearly 3,000 agricultural households in 2018-19 in Bihar, Jharkhand, Eastern Uttar Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal analyzed the impact of access to formal and informal credit on the well-being of the farmers. Research shows that access to credit has had a substantial positive impact on farmers' household incomes and raised yields of major steps crops significantly. The second tranche of the economic stimulus package announced by the central government had important decisions regarding the credit support for the farmers. It promised to provide additional credit support to small farmers through the National Bank of Agriculture and Rural Development, that's NABARD, and the Kisan Credit Card Facility. to the government statements, NABARD will extend an additional refinance support of 30,000 crores for crop loan requirements of regional rural banks, that's RRBs, and rural cooperative banks, that's RCBs, which are the main sources of credit for small and marginal farmers over and above the rupees 90,000 crores to be provided by NABARD through the normal refinance route during 2020 and 2021 financial year. The credit and refinance support is targeted to provide for the emergency working capital funding for farmers and help them to meet post-harvest requirements of the 2019 Rabi crops and take care of the costs of the current Kharif 2020 sowing. Over 3 crore farmers are expected to benefit from these initiatives. Nearly 25 lakh new KCCs have been sanctioned with a loan limit of rupees 25,000, enabling farmers to gain access to institutional credit at a concessional rates of interest. A special drive is underway to provide concessional credit at low interest through credit cards to the beneficiaries of the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, that is PM Kisan scheme, including fishermen and animal husbandry farmers and others. Almost 2.5 crore farmers will be covered and are likely to benefit from a credit flow of nearly 2 lakh crores. Thank you. interest subvention and prompt repayment incentive on crop loans due from March 1st have been extended to May 31st. The government has approved almost 63 lakh loans worth 86,000 crores in the agriculture sector, while refinancing of rupees 29,500 crore has been provided by NABARD to RRBs and RCBs in March and April. About 3 crore farmers with agricultural loans of rupees 4.22 lakh crore have availed the benefit of a loan moratorium of 3 months. In addition to this, a working capital limit of rupees 6,700 crores has been sanctioned for procurement of agriculture procedure of the state and entities since March 2020. Credit stimulus package for agriculture is timely. Among the most important constraints that Indian farmers face on the input side is the lack of access to adequate credit facilities. The provision of concessional credit through KCCs and the interest rate subvention on farm loans can come in handy for farmers preparing to sow in the Kharif season of 2020. After an initial shock for the first few days, agricultural supply chains have proved to be resilient to the national lockdown as farm operations were unaffected and large wholesale markets such as Azadpur in Delhi and Vashi in Navi Mumbai continued to function until COVID-19 cases were detected there. Prices of the most food commodities have not spiked as was popularly speculated and have remained much below the levels they reach in normal times of shortages. support extended by the government will be crucial for the Kharif sowing seasons in 2020, as shortages of labor and working capital due to the COVID-19 crisis is likely to increase the costs. In these times, interest rate subvention and extension of credit through KCCs can come as a relief to the farmers preparing to sow in the current season. In order to keep agriculture supply chains from being disrupted, a successful Kharif sowing will be crucial. India, being the largest exporter of rice in the world, will play a crucial role in fulfilling not only its own domestic demand but also providing for the food security of other countries that depend on rice imports. And as other major exporters have withdrawn from the world markets in attempt to prevent the spread of the coronavirus pandemic, this necessitates the provision of credit for farmers to purchase required inputs and undertake timely sowing of paddy. The study conducted by IFPRI found that only about 19% of agricultural households had KCCs on an average in Bihar, Jharkhand, Eastern UP, Orissa and West Bengal. This is fairly low. If the present package can deliver on its promise, providing all PM Kisan beneficiaries, including those engaged in animal husbandry and fisheries, with KCCs for borrowing at concessional rates of interest, it will increase coverage significantly and be a step forward, freeing small and marginal farmers from the clutches of usurious local money lenders. critical supply chains are likely to remain uninterrupted, and the threat of food supply disruptions causing food price inflation will be minimal if the government can deliver on its promises and the benefits of credit facilities reach farmers in time-bound fashion. The gains from the familiarizing farmers with institutional sources of credit and enhanced case of accessing during the current crisis will have long-term gains for benefit of the agriculture and the welfare of the farmers. Nationwide lockdown to contain the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic in India has brought economic activity to a complete standstill. During these times of crisis, when the most sectors in the economy are in slump, the agriculture sector has risen to become a beacon of hope and has promise of leading the India's economy, as at least this is the at least affected sector from the coronavirus-induced recession. The agriculture sector can not only be levered in the process of recovery, but it could also gain from this opportunity by leapfrogging into a new regime of growth, development, and enhanced farmer welfare. It is widely acknowledged that access to credit is critical, and accessing timely and good quality inputs at the time of sowing and can significantly after the post-harvest management of crops during harvest. The International Food Policy Research Institute, that's IFPRI, based on a large field survey of nearly 3,000 agriculture households in 2018-2019 in Bihar, Jharkhand, Eastern Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, West Bengal, analyzed the impact of access to formal and informal credit on the well-being of the farmers. research shows that access to credit has had substantial positive impact on farmers' household incomes and raised yields of major staple crops significantly. The second tranche of the economic stimulus package announced by the central government had important decisions regarding the credit support for small farmers. It promised to provide additional credit support to small farmers through the National Bank of Agriculture and Rural Development. According to the government statements, NABARD will extend an additional refinance support of 30,000 crores for crop loan requirement of regional rural banks and rural cooperative banks, which are the main sources of credit for small and marginal farmers. Over and above the rupees 90,000 crore to be provided by NABARD through the normal refinance route during the 2020 and 2021 financial year. Meanwhile, the credit and refinance support is targeted to provide for the emergency working capital funding for the farmers and help them meet post-harvest requirements of the 2019 rabi crops and take care of the costs of the current Kharif 2020 sowing season. Over 3 crore farmers are expected to benefit from the initiatives. Thank you. transaction with a loan limit of rupees 25,000, enabling farmers to gain access to institutional credit at a concessional rate of interest. A special drive is underway to provide concessional credit at low interest through credit cards to the beneficiaries of the Kisan Pradhan Mantri Samman Nidhi, that's PM Kisan scheme, including fishermen and animal husbandry farmers. Almost 2.5 crore farmers will be covered and are likely to benefit from a credit flow of nearly 2 lakh crores. Interest subvention and prompt repayment incentive on crop loans due for March 1st have been extended to May 31st. The government has approved almost 63 lakh loans worth rupees 86,600 crores in agriculture sector, while refinancing of rupees 29,500 crore has been provided by NABARD to RRBs and RCBs in March, April. About 3 crore farmers with agriculture loans of rupees 4.22 lakh crore have been availed the benefit of a loan moratorium of 3 months. In addition to this, a working capital limit of rupees 6,700 crore has been sanctioned for the procurement of the agriculture produce of state government entities since March 2020. Talk about the credit stimulus package for agriculture. It is timely. Among the most important constraints that Indian farmers face on the input side is the lack of access to adequate credit facilities. The provision of concessional credit through KCCs and the interest rate subvention on farm loans can come in handy for farmers preparing to sow in the Kharif season of 2020. After an initial shock for the first few days, agriculture supply chain have proved to be resilient to the national lockdown as farm operations were unaffected and large wholesale markets such as Azadpur in Delhi and Vashi in Navi Mumbai continued to function until COVID-19 cases were detected there. Prices of the most food commodities have not spiked as was popularly speculated and have remained much below the levels they reach in normal times of shortages. The credit support extended by the government will be crucial for the Kharif sowing season in 2020 as shortages of labor and working capital due to the COVID-19 crisis is likely to increase the costs. In these times, interest rates, subvention and extension of credit through KCCs can come as a relief to farmers preparing to sow in the current season. In order to keep agricultural supply chains from being disrupted, a successful Kharif sowing season will be crucial. Additionally, India, being the largest exporter of rice in the world, will play a crucial role in fulfilling not only its own domestic demand, but also providing for the food security of the other countries that depend on the rice imports, as other major exporters have withdrawn from the world markets as an attempt to prevent the spread of the coronavirus pandemic. This necessitates the provision of credit for farmers to purchase required inputs and undertake timely sowing of the paddy. A study conducted by IFPRI found that only about 19% of agricultural households had KCCs on average in Bihar, Jharkhand, Eastern Uttar Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal. This is fairly low. If the present package can deliver on its promise of providing all PM Kisan beneficiaries, including those engaged in animal husbandry, fisheries with KCCs for borrowing at concessional rates of interest, it will increase coverage significantly and be a step towards freeing small and marginal farmers from the clutches of usurious local moneylenders. Agricultural supply chains are likely to remain uninterrupted, and the threat of food supply disruptions causing food price inflation will be minimal if the government can deliver on the promises it and the benefits of the credit facilities that it made, reaching the farmers in a time-bound fashion. The gains from the familiarizing farmers with institutional sources of the credit and enhanced case of accessing during the current crisis will have long-term gains for the benefit of agriculture and the welfare of the farmers. rains and raised yields of major staple crops significantly. The second tranche of economic stimulus package announced by the central government had important decisions regarding the credit support for small farmers. It promised to provide additional credit support to small farmers through the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. Edition of Lifeline. We'll be back tomorrow, same time with another topic. Till then, take care.